स्टार्ट सिमरन।
ओके सो गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। आई वुड लाइक टू प्रेजेंट द प्रेजेंटेशन बेस्ड ऑन द केस स्टडी ऑफ लॉस ऑफ ग्रासलैंड इन कान्हा नेशनल पार्क ड्यू टू सक्सेशन। सो टू बिगिन विद आई वुड लाइक टू क्लियर दैट दिस स्टडी इट कंसिस्ट डाटा फ्रॉम 5 decades एंड इट डज नॉट हैव प्रीवियस डाटा और द डाटा डेट इज और द वेजिटेशन डेट इज देयर राइट नाउ। So first of all, these two pictures that we are seeing over here, both of these are the satellite photographs of the Silipura grassland and Rona grassland. Here in Silipura grassland, we can see that 363 hectare of the total grassland area was there in 1962. And soon this grassland area, it reduced. Till 2011, it reduced to 200 hectare. But what happened to the rest of the grassland area? So it get covered by trees. The woody plants that had invaded over several years in these grassland. Similarly, here also in Rhonda grassland, the whole grassland area, it reduced to 135 hectares in 2011, and rest of the area that was present in these grasslands were covered up by the trees, woody plants. And this had happened because of the succession, because after nudation that had occurred several years back, these grasslands were formed. And after these grasslands, when they die and they accumulate into the soil texture changed, and along with it, environmental changes also occurred, and this environmental changes they resulted in the invasion of new species of woody plants. So some of the plants like Caidia calasina, then Buchenia lansen, Terminalia chebula, and also Butia monosperma. These are the species that had invaded in these grasslands. So these species that have invaded, they are also called as serial species because they have replaced, or they are replacing, these two main grasslands of Kanha National Park. And these grasslands are being replaced by these trees because the environment wants to achieve a climax condition or climax forest condition, which requires a lot of years to be achieved. So it is a slow process that is still ongoing. And one more thing that is observed over here is this, that Butia monosperma, it have invaded more than other species of the Rhonda grassland and also Silipura grassland. But when we see in this chart, this is a IVI value chart, which means importance value index. So this chart shows the dark color is the black color box is the data of control species in the surrounding. And the gray color is the data of species that have ingressed or invaded in the grassland. So here it shows that Butia monosperma, which is this one, it was never present in the surrounding areas, but it have ingressed or invaded in the forest. This happened because the grassland, the soil in the grassland, or we can say near the river valleys, it was muddy, and the environment had also changed itself. So these changes, they favored the growth of Butia monosperma. And here we can see that it is in maximum number. So the factor, or we can say the whole succession, is said to be mainly caused by biotic and abiotic factors, which is also called as allogenic or autogenic factors. So these two factors have played an important role in conversion of these grassland into forest, or they're still getting converted. It is not fully converted into forest. And the factors are like human induced climate change, which means the pollution that we create, that eventually lead into the increase in carbon dioxide. Similarly, cutting of trees and other factors, they have played an important role, and also the effect of rising carbon dioxide level. It have also affected the growth of particular life, which is some plant species or woody plant species, and it has suppressed the others, which is most of the grass species. Now, if you see, then here in grassland, there are about 30 species of grasses that are found, but there are about over 500 species of trees that are found here. So it shows that how these trees, they have adapted themselves and how the environment had also changed itself to favor the growth of these trees. So they are slowly reaching towards the climax community condition, but to achieve that condition, it will take a lot of time, because this was the data of five decades. In 5 decades, only this much had happened. But if this process keeps on going, then this area will also get covered by forest. So this will happen in next few decades, but it can only happen if the succession is progressive. If the succession is retrogressive, or if it is a deflected succession, which means because of human activity, it can get deflected from its own path of progression, then it might take more time, or it may not take place. So lastly, I would like to say that this study was mainly focused on the grassland, because Kanha National Park, it is a place where the herbivores are very large in amount, and the reduction in the grassland area is the matter of growing concern for the researchers and for the community of herbivores, for example, Barasingha. So this is why this whole study or case study was done. And this work was carried out as part of project entitled Energy and Mass Exchange in Vegetative System under ISRO Geosphere and Biosphere programs. And these two links one can visit, because it have good source. It is a good source for this whole case study. That's all from my side. Thank you.